Hello YouTube, welcome to a commentary channel where I discuss anything, everything. I have a go at lots of different topics that sometimes have impacted my life or something that I may be interested in. And today I have got a really fascinating topic for you. And it's called Forgotten Inventions That Could Have Changed the World. Now, throughout history, countless inventions have faded into obscurity, either because they were too advanced for their time, or they met with resistance, or were deliberately suppressed. Here are 10 remarkable inventions that could have reshaped the world had they succeeded. Number 1, the starlight material. The inventor was Morris Ward. What it did. Starlight was a heat-resistant material capable of withstanding extreme temperatures up to 10,000 degrees Celsius and radiation. It could protect objects from intense heat without degrading. The country was United Kingdom. The year was 1986. Why it failed. Ward refused to share the formula for fear of exploitation, and the material's full potential was never realized. So that sounds to me like this man was selfish. Non-judgment, but if I had something, think of what this could have done. There is the potentials for it. Space, the potentials to where for firemen, you know, to go into fires. So that's very sad. Now, number 2, I don't know if I'm going to pronounce this right, the coronavisor, CHRONOVISOR. The inventor was Father Pellegrino Ernanti, ERNETTI, claimed. So in other words, he claimed it. What it did. Allegedly, this device allowed users to view past events by capturing residual energy in the atmosphere. Wow. Country, Italy, the year 1950s. Why it failed. Many dismiss the coronavisor as a hoax, but if real, it could have revolutionized history and archaeology. Imagine you could have looked back past at Julius Caesar, Cleopatra. Wow. Number 3, the Wardenclyffe Tower, wireless electricity. Inventor, my favorite, Nikola Tesla. What it did. Tesla's tower aimed to transmit wireless electricity globally, providing free energy to all. The country, United States, the year 1901 to 1906, why it failed. Funding was withdrawn when investors like J.P. Morgan realized free energy would undermine their profits from conventional power systems. Now, this was 1901 to 1906. We're nearly in the year 2025, and we're still using fossil fuels. And something very interestingly, The papers or patent for this was looked at by the uncle of Trump, and these patent papers have disappeared. Trump's uncle has a lot to answer for, but let me not go down the track of politics, because I do know I have some people who dislike me for my political views. So let's continue with inventions. Number four, the Dynatac mobile phone prototype. The inventor was Dr. Martin Cooper. What it did, although commercially successful later, the original prototype for mobile phones in 1973 faced skepticism, as it seemed unnecessary in an era dominated by landlines. The country, United States. The year, 1973. Why it took time? It took another decade before society embraced mobile phones as practical. Sorry about this.
This is a reminder.
Hold on. Sorry about that. I'm not going to redo this. That was my Alexa. Let's go on to number five. So, Alexa, another good invention. But anyway, let's continue. Number five, the steam-powered car. The inventor was Abner Doble. What it did, the Doble steam car could start instantly, ran on water and steam, and was more efficient than gasoline-powered vehicles. Country, United States. The year, 1920s. Why it failed. The rise of the internal combustion engine, along with lobbying by oil companies, ensured the steam car's demise. Again, fossil fuels. Number six, the M drive, electromagnetic propulsion. The inventor, Roger Scheuer. What it did, a revolutionary propulsion system that supposedly created thrust without fuel, potentially enabling space travel at a fraction of the cost. The country, United Kingdom. The year, the early 2000s. Why it failed. Controversial and criticized for defying Newtonian physics, it remains under research despite initial success claims. So, because it didn't meet physics that Newton, Newton has a law, Newton's law of physics. Because it defied Newton's law of physics, it wasn't researched properly. Now, we know that Einstein came up with theories that defied Newton's law of physics. So, again, wonder why. Now, I said to you that there was going to be 10, but I've miscounted. There's only going to be 9, I'm sorry. So, number 8 is the anti-gravity device. The inventor was Thomas Townsend Brown. What it did, Brown's work suggested that high voltage electricity could create anti-gravitational effects, potentially enabling vehicles to defy gravity. Remember the Elmer was the dog, and they had a robot and the cars were flying through the sky. There was a cartoon. Anyway, the country, United States. The year, the 1920s. Wow! This is what we common people don't know about. We're not taught this in history. This car, or this prototype, enabled vehicles to defy gravity. Why it failed. The technology was either suppressed or discredited, with some theorizing military involvement. So the military got involved. I wouldn't surprise me. So this is, number eight now. The Sea Orbiter. The inventor, Jacques Rougerie. R-O-U-G-E-R-I-E. Rougerie. What it did. A floating research station designed to explore the ocean's depths, fostering advancements in marine biology and technology. Country, France. The year, 1999. Why it failed. Despite initial interest, funding issues stalled the project, leaving it unfinished. Number 10, well, this is really, I thought I had 10, but this is, number 9. Don't mean to confuse you guys. Getting a bit of dementia. Someone invents a dementia machine. That would be great. So, the perpetual motion machine. The inventor. I wouldn't have a clue how to pronounce this. B-H-A with an umlaut. S-K-R-A-R-A. Bahaska the second, and many others. What it did. The concept of a machine that could run indefinitely without an external energy source has intrigued inventors for centuries. Bahaska II, a 12th century mathematician, designed an early prototype. So this is in the 1100s. Already in the 1100s, someone had thought of a machine. Country, India. The year, about 1150. Why it failed. It violates the laws of thermodynamics, making it scientifically impossible, though it inspires modern energy innovations. So, coming back, I also want to tell you that a few years ago, now when I mean a few years ago, I'm talking about 20 years ago, I heard of an invention that coming out of England, they had an invention where they could put probes on your mind, and while you slept, they could actually see what you were dreaming. Whether that has happened, I don't know, but that's what I heard of 20 years ago. Now, let me tell you something. I was born in 1961. When we grew up, or when I grew up in the 1970s, we really believed by the year 2000 that we would be, cars would be buzzing up in the sky, and there would be this, not like what it is, even though technology has advanced so much. And another thing, I didn't have a scientific calculator till grade 10, so I was 15. The first computer came into high schools the year after I left high school, 1978. 1979, they brought in computers. So for my age group, we have seen great advances in technology, but we really thought that, yeah, they would be traveling like, I wish I could remember this cartoon. The Jetsons, got it! I knew the Jetsons. That's how in the 70s we thought we would be living by the year 2000. If you're new here, thank you for coming to view me. And if you've seen me before, welcome back. And I will be doing a few more content as the days go by. My court case is done, dusted, over. I filled out a discontinuance form. I can't proceed without legal representation, and no lawyer wants to help me because the amount you can get is a set amount by law, and right or wrong, it's what it is, what it is. And even if my case was worth more than that, that's the ceiling, and that is. So welcome everybody to my YouTube channel. I never push to like or subscribe, but I do ask for comments, please. So if you would like to leave a comment, I would be very grateful. Thanks for watching. So in the end, I did come up with 10 because I remembered, oh, actually 11. It was around about the late 1970s, and there was an idea that if there was an idea that, like a rocket, so instead of an airplane traveling, say, 23 hours from Australia to England, that you went up in this rocket and you went straight up into the outer part, and while you're going straight up, the earth rotates, and so instead of 23 hours, it would have only taken an hour. So go up, say, from Brisbane, the earth's rotating, and then come down, and then you were in England. I don't know what happened to that prototype. We are not told, but it's time we are told. Tesla's invention would have allowed energy, free energy, for the whole world for 1,000 years. But there is, let's be realistic here, there is money in oil and fossil fuel. And that's how the rich and the elite are, look, we all know. And even though we know, and we know that there are cleaner ways, we are being suppressed because this is how the elite, whoever you want to call them, have got their money. And they also make money in war. War is built on fossil fuels and oil as well. But anyway, I'm off the subject. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a really good weekend. I will be doing another video soon, and that's my videos for the weekend. Love you guys. Be nice to one another. It takes nothing to be nice. And don't judge. You don't know. You haven't walked in someone else's shoes. Okay. Love, light, and blessings. Gems done. Bye.